G'day all, David here. This is my first official YouTube video in lockdown, so I'd like to put this out there just for anyone who's wants to see something interesting. Hopefully you'll find it interesting. So today I'm making this little lidded box. It's a loose fit. It's not a friction fit, mainly because our environment down here hot to cold, and there's so much moisture around when it's cold that these boxes warp and you'll never get the lid off. Also, I'm not really a fan of the suction fit, mainly because when it sits on the dresser or on a bench, when you want to take something out of it, you can't just lift the lid off like so. You end up pulling the whole vessel up, which takes sort of the delicateness away from it. Yeah, so when I say loose fit, it is only marginal. You can just hear the movement. We're going to do a little bit of detail on the inside. We're going to concentrate on form. Burn some little detail lines on the side to disguise where we've taken the tenon out, or the piece of wood that will become the tenon inside. So we're going to be making it out of a piece of black marae, which is New Zealand heaviest wood. It turns a lot like olive. Sorry about the noise upstairs, that's the kids running around. Tools we're going to be using: half inch bowl gouge for shaping the outside, homemade parting tool for our separating the lid from the bottom of the box, and creating the tenon. We're going to be using the Munro Mini 6 hollower straight. We might even use a Owen bin, which is a slight curve as well. And a couple of little point tools just to create our little lines and some wire to burn in. We'll probably be using two chucks on this job. You can do it with one. On our website, our club website here, South Auckland Woodturners Guild, they have many plans. I think they have around 7 or 8 different boxes that you can do, as well as a whole heap of other projects. And this shows you how to do it with one chuck. I like using two chucks because I have two chucks, and yeah, so have a look on there on the website. That's South Auckland Woodturners Guild. I'll put a link down below. Also, please subscribe if you can. It will help, and let me know what the feedback is as well, because yeah, I'm all new to this, and we'll see if it's worth cracking on. All right, cheers. Let's get into it. Okay, here we are. We have our block of black marae, or whatever timber you desire. It's roughly square. Now we're just going to find each centre. Using Vivid so you can see it a lot clearer. Then we're just going to mark it. We can either use a punch or a point tool or something to just create a little indexing point. I'm using a spring-loaded punch tool. I'm going to use step centers. So same thing, spur drive, but it's a Robert Sorby step center and Robert Sorby live step center. The thing I like about these is they're a very safe tool. You have twice as much bite, but when you get a dig in, instead of the piece jumping out of the step centers, they usually just spin, and then you tighten the tailstock up again and you reapply pressure and it drives the wood again. Alright, so we'll set that up. Centre. So we need to use a roughing gouge, spindle roughing gouge, to rough this down to a cylinder shape and put two spigots in either end. So we'll quickly rough this down. I'm going to turn the dust extraction on, quickly hone that down, and then we'll put the spigots on. Now we're going to put our two spigots on. Okay, so we've now roughed it out to a round cylinder shape. We have our tenons on either side. Now we can place that in the chuck. We have our chuck on now on the bottom part of our vessel. Now we're just going to shape it out. Okay, I'm just starting to think about shape now. We've put our radius in the bottom, and now I'm thinking about height. I'm quite happy with that. By the time I take the tenon out of the middle, the joining tenon, we should be right. Then we'll work out bringing it down, final shaping once we have the two fitted up. So now the next step is to work out our line. So I'm looking at the piece being around probably 60 mil high, and the piece will be roughly about 65 to 67 mils wide. So I want the lid to be starting about there, which is 10 mil. So that'll be our cut and our tenon. And there, like so. So wherever you decide that you'd like that tenon to be, Okay, we'll cut that out. Looking at they're going about 2.5 mils to 3 mil. Going in like so, just slightly turning it a little bit, just so we can create a little bit of room inside there. So what we've worked out, to be, we have about 3 mil of tenon, which the lid's going to sit up, sit on. Our cut is about 1.5 mil to 1.75 millimeter. So now we'll install our other chuck, because I want to keep this all nice and lined up. Another little thing I quite like is when you've roughed it out, because you haven't got a nice finish, put a reference line across the two, so that when you separate them and you come back together to re-turn it, and that you match it up perfectly. Morse taper with a live center thread of the same chuck that I want to use. And that just screws on like so. Turn that around, grab that. Now what I like about this is after I've parted those two off, which we're going to do right now. Now, every point we have this nice and true in our chuck now. And we can just put that aside, ready for creating our lid. Now we're going to drill our inside out down to our desired depth.
Okay, so we have our 50 mil false nugget in our jacket chuck. Now we're just going to drill our hole for the inside out. Halfway, which is the fat part of the hollow form, or the lid box. So essentially we're going to come down to about halfway. Now we need to work out our finished depth. So I'm just marking on the drill bit the final depth that we want.
For that, we'll set up for the lid. Okay, so we've bored our hole, rough bored it, all ready for our shape. So now we're just going to concentrate on our lid, making our non-friction lid. From there, put it all back together, finally shape it, sand it, have it all ready to go. Then we can start boring it out on the inside. Okay, so we have our other chuck with our lid on the lathe. Now we're just going to map out our size of our rebate that's going to go in here to accept our tenon. So it's 67 mil. So now we're just going to bulk out the middle part. Now, because we have this quite thin on here, we now have this area behind that's supporting the center. So now we can put a little detail in there. So we're just going to use a texturing tool for that. We want to be down around 500 RPM, and we're going to put the tool on about a 30 degree angle. So essentially we're aiming the bottom of the tool at center and sitting on a 25 to 30 degree angle. So what we're doing is a little spiral in the centre, then using a point tool of your choice. I just use a screwdriver. So what we end up with, I'm not sure if you can see that, but it's just a little spiral detail with two little detail lines around it. With the inside, we're just going to put a bit of super glue on the inside. So that's our finish. We can go in there, and once that's dry, and give it a nice little sand with maybe 400 grit, maybe 600 grit, clean up that front face, put a little bit of wax on there, and that's that finished. Okay, so now we're just going to put our live threaded chuck holder on. Make sure our coil is out far enough. Now, because we have those reference lines, we can now meet them up nice and snug, like so. And we're all back to one piece of wood again. Now we'll just look at sanding. So I'm going to sand starting with 180, then 220, then 320.
Now 240. Now 320.
Send that out. Now we're just going to do our little details, our little detailed burn lines. So how I do them is I first find our center, which is our lid, do a little one in there, then maybe a mil and a half. On one side, mil and a half on the other side. Now, using a very thin wire, cranking our speed up to maybe close to 1,000. Do our center line first. And our next line, like so. Then we just go over it again with our 320 sandpaper. Just so you know, it really helps when you actually have the 320 sandpaper on the tool. Take our lid off, like so. Put that aside and get into our hollowing.
floating cap just to clean everything up.
So we're quite happy in there. So we've got a little recess in here, or undercut, which just allows for a little tenon piece, then a nice continuous curve. Okay, now we're just going to give it a little blow out. Now we're just going to give it a little wipe out with a bit of super glue. Little bit of paste wax, and then finish it up with a bit of steel wool. Okay, so this is the paste wax I'm going to use. It's just a normal paste wax conditioner, this one that I make. So all we're going to do is just grab a little bit out. Put the paste wax in there, give it a little sand with 400, wipe out any excess in there. Go in there with the steel wool, and all we're trying to do is knock back that shine. So we've just created just a little bit of less shine on it. Let's see if I can get the light off it. Okay, so what we're going to do is exactly the same to the inside of the lid. Wipe off any excess. And again, get a steel wool to knock off that shine. Okay, so we have our lid. Just softly give it a little sand up to 400 grit. Now, using a bit of masking tape, about a mil down from the top, we're just going to mask that lid on. Like so, and we're going to release our chuck, come up with our live center, which will match right into our little hole. Just having a little look. A few little ridges in there that we can clean up. But we're happy with that curve. We've sort of got to imagine what we're looking at it, because we're going to cut it down and go back inwards. So we'll just do a little bit more cleaning up. Bring those revs up a bit more. Just shear scraping those little ridges out. Now going to a spindle gouge, which I forgot to mention. now we're just removing the matter, trying to free that up. And top that off. Still pushing that bevel in against the lid. Not too hard because we don't want to burn the actual lid. Okay, so we have that all nice and pretty now. It's quite a clean surface, so we'll probably start with maybe 320. If I can find my scissors. Hidden under shavings. And when we're dealing with thin lids and walls of hollow forms, we always go from one direction to the other. It just creates a little bit of cooling time. Now we might just do a little bit of texturing again. So what I want is a nice little coru in there, and you're using a point tool or detailing. A little bit of steel wool. So how I take boxes off the bottom part of the lid box, or sorry, the foot of the lid box, is I have this piece of timber here that has my same spindle thread. Inside has a little cup with a little bit of foam. Using our thread adapter again. We will be driving the piece foam mat
with a vacuum system on my lathe.
Bring our life center up again. Turning the foot off. Now, a good practice here before you start cutting too much of this material away is just put a ruler across and make sure you have a flat. So that's all nice and flat under there. Right, now we'll turn our vacuum on. Now, people are very tempted just to snap that that little nib off. I never do. The problem is if you snap that, it could possibly tear strands from inside the piece out because we are end grain. So what I find the best, using a knife, just a little nick along, trying to aim the blade upwards. So all you're doing is cutting it. Now we can just power sand that off, put it all together. Okay, so we've just dremeled that off. Hand sanding that down. Just with a bit of 180. 240 and 320. Okay, so now it's just a matter of getting our lid. Like so. Now I'm going to hand sand that down to 400 grit, ready for spraying. So now I always spray the vessel all as one first with one coat, then flip it up and finish the bottom. The problem is if you finish the bottom first with spraying a coat over it, it wicks down and creates a shadow line, and then when you finally finish the foot then go back up to the top, you end up with a silly line that you'll always see. So always think about how you're finishing. So spray the top and sides first, then go down, spray the bottom, finish the foot nicely, then put it up and do your final spray.